What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Ari Chambers here, and this is Off Top, and we're here with the Las Vegas Aces. Let's get it.
Oh, what you gotta say, KB?
Just fly.
Sorry.
It's not you.
The dog is soaring.
He's like, wait a minute. So acknowledge your feelings. Acknowledge, like, what you're feeling and know it's okay.
Oh, that's a plus for us.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm gonna tell my story a little bit more.
Are you always this quiet?
I mean,
oh, what you gotta say, KB?
I ain't got nothing to say.
I plead the fifth.
Until I get to know you.
Yeah.
So what would it take to crack? Because I'm determined, okay? I know that we just met 30 seconds ago.
Yeah.
Though I've been covering you for a decade, that's fine. What does it take? Because I know the audience or the fans out there, the WNBA fans are like, God, we love Jackie. We want to go up for Jackie. Off top, who is Jackie Young?
I mean, I'm shy, I'm quiet. I mean, until I get to know somebody and then I open up a little bit. But I'm pretty quiet. Like,
so this is what we see is what we get.
Yeah, pretty much.
Have you cracked it?
I cracked the code already.
I get a little bit more.
I see you and it's just so bright every single time. I'm like, God, I feel like we're besties. And it's just like, KB, like,
you already know.
Oh, so off top, who is KB?
Somebody who's fun to be around, always bringing energy, and just fly.
Oh, okay.
Oh, talk it, pop off. Okay. What them DMs looking like?
We ain't gonna talk about them DMs, but we gonna keep that off camera.
Look, Alysha, I don't know how you, you dealing with the youngest now. Like, you dealing with the youngest. Before I even get to how you deal with the youngest, off top, who is Alysha Clark?
I'm chill, I'm reserved. I think just like an observer. Mm-hmm. I like to sit back and observe people. Kind of like Jackie, like when I get to know you, mm-hmm. I open up a little bit more. I'm friendly, but you know, I'm just not sociable. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm friendly, but not sociable.
Does it ever get hard for you two in particular to have to sit down and like talk to people exhaustingly during media days?
I mean, but once you've done it for so long, mm-hmm. You know how to do it, but in the beginning, yeah, it's hard because it's one, you don't really know these people. They're asking you questions about you, your life, what you think, how you move, and it's just like, how is this going to be used? I don't really know you. I don't trust you yet. So it can be hard, but you know, as you get older and go through this, you know what you can say and what you can allow people in on.
Mm-hmm. And Jackie, what do you wish that you have been asked in the past few years that you haven't been asked, and maybe we can start there and start chipping away because I'm determined.
That's tough.
I'm sure it is, Jackie.
Yeah.
Sorry, it's not
the
you.
Dog is soaring.
The dog is sleeping. He said, y'all talking still?
This year, I'm gonna do better. I'm gonna tell my story a little bit more. And so that's what we're working on. But yeah, I mean, pretty much you get what you get from me.
Okay.
I'm just like pretty shy to myself, you know, pretty private. And so, yeah, like I don't post much on Instagram. Like you just see me playing basketball, tunnel fits, a couple things like that.
What's a typical Jackie Young post?
Oh, I mean, if it's not a game day picture, it's like a crop top.
I was gonna say, slaying at a crop top.
With the arms out, don't forget the arms.
With the peace sign.
Yeah,
So those out there who want to know how to be Jackie Young.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Yep.
But KB, like that. Your TikTok been popping. I just want to know the social media aspect of you. You're really, really, not only are you a bright light in person, but online you really showcase everything that is you that just makes us all warm and fuzzy inside.
Yeah.
How are you able to maintain that light? What do we expect from you behind the screen?
You know, life is about having fun. Mm-hmm. You only get one life, so, you know, make the most of it. And then my dad recently got down here, and I've been hanging out with him. And so I've seen him being 53 and how much fun he's been having. Like, I think that's where I get it from. It's just, it doesn't matter how old you are or how young you are. Like, I'm going to stay young forever. I'm going to always have that spirit. And I just always try to bring the light into other people's lives.
I mean, you are the youngest.
Yes, I am.
You're a child.
I am.
Really?
You ain't got to say child, but I am.
Check me. Don't make the DMs. Don't mess up the DMs.
Yeah,
okay, she's so not a child.
I mean, AJ ain't nothing but a number, so.
See, this is why. Get on, Alysha, because how you going to deal with that?
You know, it helps keep me young.
It helps keep me
young.
That's it. I keep my dad young. He keeps me young, so.
Who is, like, the one person on your team that you're like, I'm a take her into my shenanigans and foolishness, and we gonna run the town.
I love it. A Jackie Young out here moment.
Yes. You need a Jackie moment out here.
You said on camera, we're doing better this year.
Yes.
What is doing better?
I guess being seen more, you know? Mm-hmm. Posting more, talking more. Yeah. Just being there, you know, and not so just shying away, staying in the background, you know?
Uh-huh. She's doing better because Coach did compliment her about speaking up in practice. Okay. So, that, you know, that's a plus for us.
Yeah. Okay. You know, Alysha, you're new to the team, but you're not new to this league. Mm-hmm. You've been around. You've been around. How have you been able to stay in this league so long?
I think a big part of it is just staying true to who I am. And, like, he's had enough camera time for today.
I'm about to take a nap.
He's like, Mom, you not coming?
Look, that's literally, he's like, wait a minute. You can go, it's fine. I promise, I'm gonna be right here. He's like, all right. It's like I talk to him like a human. No, but I think it's just being true to who I am and like what got me into this league and being confident in that. You know, it's like every year you come in, there's new young talent coming in and it's, you know, the death of comparison. It's like, oh, if I'm not doing this or I'm doing that, and then you kind of lose who you are. So I think for me, I've been able to sustain because I know who I am. Mm-hmm. I know what's gotten me here. I know what's helped me win at every level. I know what's helped me win in, you know, this league. And I know what I bring. There's not many people that can bring what I bring. And, you know, I want to be cocky and be like, I know for sure there's nobody in this league that can do the things that I do as consistently as I have over time, the way that I do them. Mm. And so for me, that's just kind of what I hang my hat on. It's like, yeah, I improve every year and I come in and I'm working on something different to be better. But what you see for me on the court is you see that consistently year in and year out, and I think that's what helped me be here so long.
I think you have such a healthy balance being off the grid and on the grid at the same time. Mm-hmm. How do you manage that balance?
I mean, I think for me, just because I am more like reserved, it's easy for me to like disconnect from everything. And mm-hmm. I think because of, you know, I'm on that bubble generation where we had the thing, like, you had the home phone, and you had the CD, like, all those things.
Y'all don't know nothing. You might. You don't know nothing about it.
Where you had to be like, hey, I'm taking the phone at 7 o'clock because don't mm-hmm. make sure nobody calls.
And then don't let there be internet.
Oh, my gosh. The dial-up, like, people don't even understand, like, sitting there waiting for that nee-nee-nee just it's, to log in the AIM.
And it's not even an ancient artifact. It's literally... When were you born?
2000. See, you see how they do me?
Right. And then the other, on the flip side of that is like just finding a way to like, kind of like KB, like be a light for other people, be a source of inspiration for other people, be a source of kindness and love for other people, and just being able to emulate that through my social media, through, you know, communication and contact that I have with people. Just making sure that, you know, when I leave somewhere, when I leave a conversation, when I leave a room, that people remember how I made them feel. Mm. And so I think that's something that I really pride myself on. So yeah, I think that's how I get the balance.
Yeah, and Jackie, like, but how do you make yourself heard in a space that might not be like, you might not be comfortable being like, this is what needs to happen. But shout out to Coach saying your voice is there.
Yeah, I know, I've been talking a little bit more. No, but I think it's just getting out of my shell a little bit more and challenging myself. It's really no different than me being in the off season working on my jump shot, you know? And so I think it's just trying to grow as a person and just becoming more comfortable in who I am.
I will, I'm gonna jump in.
Please.
Only being here
this
for 2 weeks.
This ain't no panel, I mean, this is a discussion.
But like just being here these 2 weeks, mm-hmm. like she has a presence about her. Mm-hmm. Like even though she's not vocally there, you feel her presence when she's doing things. Mm-hmm. And so while, yeah, she may not be a vocal leader in that way and that's something she's growing in, but just like, her work and what she does is leading. And so she makes herself heard by being seen and felt, if that makes sense. And that's just me being there 2 weeks and just observing, you know, my teammates and the surroundings. So I think that's something that, you know, not a lot of people have because she can walk into a room, and I say this confidently, like a room of CEOs of Fortune 500 companies, and you're gonna feel her presence and people are gonna know she's there. That's what she emulates, so.
And you
especially
know,
when she be jumping 30 on scrimmage.
Silently, right? Just
casually.
Running through you. Lay up and one.
And she'll give a little, you know, she'll give a little flex and look at you, you know? And
that's not a look. Yeah, what's like, the look,
she gives a little look. look? What's the look?
I only give that to Jessie.
Heavy, what's the look?
I can't really get a look because she don't really express it. But like, she did get an N1. She had like, she had like 30 in the beginning. And then she got an N. It was a tough N1. She had like a heavy cross and then lay. And she was like, N1.
Yeah.
Okay, Jackie. Uh-huh. And then Chelsea was on our team. So Chelsea going up to Jackie like, chill out. Like, don't be, how you doing this? Wait till the season.
Chill out. But you know, you're on a team full of dogs, right?
Yes.
And this is your rookie year, won a championship. You were surrounded by so much talent. You are so talented. I mean, you have to be to make a roster and be the number one team in the WNBA. How do you find your role transitioning from college to the pros? And like, what was that like? And just like trying to mesh and stay on the team.
I don't think it really was different for me basketball-wise, coming from a system that plays like Becky, like how she wants to play. She, on defense, she just wants you to make reads. When you're on offense, she wants you to make reads. And it's all about defense with her. If you don't play defense, you ain't getting in the game. And that's what it is.
That's what it is.
And so for me, was just, you know, just taking advantage of my opportunities when she puts me in the game. Knowing if I'm not going to get in or not, doesn't matter. I'm getting paid for what I love to do. Mm-hmm. I'm around some of the best players in the league. And so you can't get nothing better than that. And then winning a championship your first year, come on, man. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of people are doing that. So
it's a parade.
It's a blessing. It's inside. A parade inside my city. Yeah.
Y'all's parade was lit. Oh, I was over there watching. I was like, this looks like so much fun.
We're going to enjoy it again this year. So you'll be, look forward to it.
And y'all were lit. Tell me about the atmosphere there, because I wanted to be on the float. I did nothing to be on the float, but I wanted to be up there. What was it like?
No, it was lit. I mean, the city was out for us.
Definitely.
You know, we were just having a great time.
It started from the plane ride on the way back.
Yeah.
That's when
it started when y'all were taking them pictures behind.
Oh, yeah.
It did. So it started before that. And then it didn't stop.
I was there for
until,
that.
Then it didn't stop until the Monday.
Yeah,
something like
Monday,
that.
Tuesday. Yeah,
that's a lot of endurance.
It was.
We barely made it.
We barely made it, but we made it though. We here.
Look who's back.
Look, he came back.
Look, he was like,
we here. Like, we here.
It's the parade.
It's about to be a parade now. You know how to shake.
Yeah.
You know.
Say, but I don't do it for free.
Oh, you need to
have the treats.
Mm-hmm. What you need? What treat you like?
I'm a hustler.
Okay.
That's what I teach them young.
Period. Oh, okay.
How come you won't come to me?
Okay, you sit down.
I've been trying
now.
To buy for your dog all day.
I got no buddy.
You got a dog too?
Yeah, I do. Debo. Oh.
Tell me everything about Mr. Debo.
He's crazy. He's just every time he's in, huh? He's like a rat rider. So, he's big. He was this small, and then he just got big out of nowhere. And I'm like, I can't even pick you up no more. Like,
that's how big you're getting. How old is he?
He's 5. So, he's a baby.
Jackie, Jackie, are you like not a dog person?
I was leaving for practice the other day, and I saw her out walking the dog. I was like, I can never do that.
I can never wake up.
Practice?
Dog
is like my emotional support.
Yeah, I was like.
Then I gotta, it's like a child. Like, I gotta feed you and walk you, take you out to the bathroom.
Dog sitter.
People be getting clothes for their dogs. I'm like,
as they should.
Yeah.
What's the culture of the Aces like? This is a fun team.
It is a fun team, but it's also a competitive team that knows about business. Like, we're gonna have our fun, but we're gonna also come and compete because that's what we do. It's in our blood.
Mm-hmm. Great description. Yeah. I agree with that. Yeah. Not our business, baby. I tried it and I was like, this ain't for me.
Try what?
The tortilla slap thing.
You ain't seen the video from last year? We was
slapping. Did it hurt?
It hurt.
See, that wasn't even like something that I was in my list of things to do.
No, that hurts.
Oh, no, it hurts.
So they got you to do social content, a little TikToking.
Yeah.
But never the hips. Never the hips going.
She gonna get the hips.
You know what? The first thing I said to Jackie, I was like, would you be down for a TikTok today? She's like, what kind of TikTok? Never mind.
Never mind. You ain't gonna do it.
These are hills I don't want to climb. These are battles I don't want. Yeah. But as far as locker room culture goes, how do y'all think y'all are gonna mesh together this season?
I mean, I think much of the same like they were last year. Mm-hmm. Like the pieces that, you know, we brought in, myself and Candace, Kayla, like everybody is, you fit personality-wise, like just good humans. But also people that know how to work, people that know when it's time to like put the laughter and jokes aside and like get busy. And so, you know, it's when you have people like that that can be good humans as well as good basketball players and like in that space, that's what makes teams special. And that's something that Candace and I always talk about. Like we just want to be in a locker room that's, like, we want to be in a good locker room because we know the difference that it can make. It can win or lose you 5 to 6 games a season. And it's like, when you're in a good locker room, you want that. And so, I mean, for us, like, you see it. Like, we don't have to force conversation. We allow people to be themselves. We don't, you know, not trying to make anybody feel uncomfortable, allowing people to just come in and be as they are. And that's what, I mean, for me, I'm like, that's what it's about. That's what makes a good team.
And you've grown into your own. Off the court, I mean, you were always KB, but like you've really grown as a human, I feel like, even within the past year. So how have you been able to just really step into you and let yourself and your light shine?
Like I said before, just being myself, honestly, just trying to stick to what I know and continue to be who I want to be, and just grow into the professional level, you know, just knowing how to be a professional, carry myself a different way, knowing that I can't be how I was when I was in high school.
How were you in high school?
We're not gonna talk about that, but this, you know, you just can't, when you go to a different level, you just can't be how you used to be. You have to bring yourself into a different light. You can't hang with certain people and
how do you,
get yourself into
I like that, because like, how do you filter out all the distractions? There are a lot of distractions when you're a pro athlete, I'm assuming. I ain't never been a pro athlete, but I'm assuming that there are a lot of distractions. How do you keep the main thing the main thing?
Just keeping certain people out your business, keeping the stuff that you don't want people to know private, like she was saying, just being private.
Which is fair.
Right, and then, you know, they have stuff where you can keep in your close friends and stuff like that, so that's what I just try to do.
Jackie, you've won it.
Look,
she's like, yeah. Yeah.
Don't be talking, Jackie, you're on the mic.
You know, you've won on every level possible, and you just, you're a little superstar. What do you want for yourself this season? What do you want next season? I hate people being like, what's your 5-year goal? Or what do you want to accomplish next? But like, what do you see for yourself?
Yeah, I think just continuing to grow, you know. I work on my game every off season. I try to come back a better player. And we set goals in the off season. But I think it's just growing. I've gotten better every single year. And so I think it's just trying to keep on doing that. Just continuing to grow my game and become a better player.
And as you keep growing your game and staying here, and you've overcome so much between personal situations and injuries, and how are you able to be mentally strong?
Therapy, honestly. for the first time I found a therapist after my dad passed. I was like, okay, I need to have somewhere where I can channel and have somebody help me with tools to be able to navigate day-to-day life. And so like just doing that. And I think for me personally, like outside of that, I've always been one that like my outlook is like, I always find the positive. Like that's my life mantra. It's like, okay, what's the positive in this? Find the positive. Because there's always one. Some days it's a lot harder than others to find one, but if you look hard enough, you're gonna find it. And so, for me, I think that's been able to help me sustain through the ups and downs of this career, injuries, personal stuff, whatever, is finding a positive. And then two, just having tools to be able to navigate through that. You know, being in prayer, being in the Word is something that I've had to grow in because there was a lapse where I was so angry about a lot of stuff. And so just kind of like getting back in to my walk and getting back into the Word to like bring me back has been like what's kept me going, especially these last 8 months. So, you know, they say you live and you learn and you find out what works for you, so.
There are a lot of people out there struggling that might not know how to reach out for help or get down on their knees and pray or find a proper therapist. What advice do you have or can you give to them who don't necessarily know how to get themselves up?
Man, because I've been there. So I think for me, the first step for me, it was finding like a glimmer of hope, something that you look forward to. Just finding that, whatever that looks like, whether it's, you know, for me, it was my niece and nephew. It was like, okay, when I'm in this like space that I'm in, I thought of them and it was like, okay, how would they feel if something happened? You know what I mean? So then that like brought me out of it. Then it was like acknowledging how I felt. So acknowledge your feelings, acknowledge like what you're feeling and know it's okay. And then be specific, what you want in somebody to talk to, like be specific about it. Like I was very specific in the therapist that I wanted because I know the things that I'm dealing with. I wanted somebody that I know could relate to me on those levels. So whether if you're suffering from depression or anxiety, like being specific, like I want a therapist that you know, is focused on anxiety or focused on depression. Because more times than not, they're probably gonna be people that have gone through it and can like feel where you are or where you're at and help you get out of it to where you feel connected in that way.
Mm-hmm. How do you protect your space, Jackie, KB? How do you protect your space and make sure that you stay in a space that's comfortable and keeps you afloat?
Yeah, I think for me, I kind of struggled early on in my career. And so for me, it was getting back to like who got me there, like my circle. I have a very tight circle. And so with being the number one pick, there's a lot of pressure and a lot of outside noise. So just going back to my circle and, you know, they supported me my whole life, my whole career. And so not worrying too much about the goals that people or the expectations that people had set for you at a certain time, because you know your number one pick is supposed to do this at a certain point. But for me, it was just not worrying about that and working on myself and my game to become the player that I wanted to be.
Have you met those expectations as a number one pick?
For me, I would say there's always goals that I still want to accomplish, but I feel like I'm on track. So.
A couple goals, a couple rings. That's fine. She's doing just fine, baby.
But yeah, really just picking it back off of what she said was just going back to your circle, you know, thinking about your why you do the things that you do. And I do it for my family, not just for myself. And so I just, when I get in tough situations, I just always try to, you know, go back to why I'm doing this and who I'm doing this for.
I want to go back to social media with you because you just have so much fun, right? You showcase a lot, which means a lot of people in your business. Mm-hmm. How do you filter them out of your business? And
not
like,
reply. No, just
leave them on rant. Just block them. No, but like when you put so much of yourself out there, people be knowing.
Yeah.
And people be knowing stuff like happen. You know what I mean? Like, how do you know when to manage that?
That's something that I'm still working on. Mm-hmm. You know, I had a conversation with somebody and they was just like, you're at the next level and people are gonna wanna know everything about what you're doing. So just try to keep it to yourself or to your inner circle. And so I'm still learning, you know, growing, being young, being around these vets who are older and know how to get through that. Just asking for advice and, you know, Jackie's been helping me with that as well. So really just trying to continue to be a professional.
And this is last because I know y'all got stuff to do. I asked y'all at the not to fall asleep, but the dog. The dog took a laugh. The dog took a laugh.
He's like, okay, my
what's
name
his name?
Is
I've been calling Snookum all day.
Little
Snookwood.
This is Sly.
Sly.
So I asked y'all the top of the show. Off top, who are y'all? I'm gonna ask you one more time. The answer can be the same. The space is yours. But off top, who's Alysha Clark?
Off top, my answer doesn't change. I'm an observer. You know, I think I'm, observer, quiet, private, friendly, welcoming.
Mm-hmm. Love it. Off top, who's KB?
KB is just good energy, good vibes, someone that you would want in your circle. And just fun to be around. That's
all. Besties. Off top, who's Jackie Young?
I mean, my answer doesn't change.
The same.
Yeah, no, I'm quiet. But, I mean, like Alysha said, I feel like my presence is known. I'll never be the loudest in the room. But I feel like my work ethic says a lot for me. And so that's who I am.